2023, and today's clash of conferences is just moments away. It's the Dallas Cowboys and the Miami Dolphins, and it's coming up next on EA Sports.
We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Dallas Cowboys and the Miami Dolphins. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. With me, as always, Charles Davis. And, Charles, we look at a matchup like this. It's really the running backs that may take center stage here today.
And in today's football, they're still valuable, not just as runners, but guys who can catch the ball as well. It's really the number of touches that determines things these days.
Cornhusker Brett Maher to get this one started. And we are underway from Hard Rock Stadium. And we will not
see. He's demonstrated incredible poise no matter what type of situation his team was in. No situation is too big.
And oh, right away, he lost the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And he'll bring this one back to the 29.
As you and I both know, one reason teams script plays to start a game is so they can practice them ahead of time. I will guarantee you, that fumble was not in the script.
You don't think they had fumble written next to play one there?
No, that was never in the script because they want to have good memories when they go into a ball game, not something that could have gone wrong.
First look at the Cowboys offense as Dak Prescott. Yard to go here on second down. Prescott down. And this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. A 20-yard touchdown. And the Cowboys use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one.
It's never fun for a defense to run on the field knowing that they're having to defend a short field. Just the idea of trying to limit an offense in that position, daunting for it.
Blue check. Check pick. Yellow. One.
Now Tua. Got a man complete to Cedric Wilson. And they're going to have this across midfield and a strong gain of 24. Play action. Now it's Tua. Going right back to Wilson. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. They go right back to it.
Lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes open, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And the Cowboys are going to get the football here as he gets this up past the 20-yard line. Well, your first drive of the first quarter, you get it down there, trying to fire it in the end zone, and big-time deflation on that play.
No doubt about it. They're moving and grooving and getting into position, and this is not the ending that they saw on this drive, is it? They had things.
That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
Well, it's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their first drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense humming here in the early going.
That's the 40 already and another first and 10. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. And a Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Jalen Phillips, the former first-rounder, getting in there for the sack. But just not much a quarterback can do there.
Guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely, because remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, You've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
And if you're wondering just how quickly that sack occurred, the next-gen stats tell us 2.6 seconds is all he had to throw the football.
Well, as a coach, you absolutely love seeing your offense find their rhythm early, and that's exactly what we've seen so far. They had a touchdown on their opening drive.
Fourth down, Prescott. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Cowboys able to hold. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And his guys will take over at their own 34-yard line.
When a team's turned it over three times in the first half, we just look at the offense and say, guys, what are you doing? But instead, we really should be looking at the defense. They've created the takeaways. Two interceptions, one caused fumble. They played awfully well swarming to the ball here.
Now with a first and 10 at their own 44. Meanwhile, Dak's throw pulled in by Lamb. And the tackle going to be made at the 38. How about the first quarter he's putting together out wide? Pretty impressive.
I think that he likes the fact that we're playing this as a day game. You know, some guys, they respond better in the evenings. For some reason, it builds up. He's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
That, I believe, will put him over 100 yards receiving for the game. Yes, it will.
They've got a real rapport going, and right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
And this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. A great effort there with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Cowboys are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead. Still first quarter, two receiving touchdowns for him. How are they going to slow him down?
I think they're thinking about altering their game plan. Whatever they came in with, now maybe you switch.
I think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. In doing so, understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open.
The ball comes out. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And so the last three drives, you've got two interceptions and a fumble. I think we know why they're losing right now.
Without question, and we've seen the evidence, just what you talked about there. If they take care of the football.
Throwing, Prescott. Able to hit his target, Lamb. And he's going to get this down near the 25. Talk about a big first half. Already has the two touchdowns, adding to his receiving total there, picking up the first down.
He's coming off the line so fast. I think he's intimidating the defensive backs. First down to keep him at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
Important to do, especially under pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final.
Incomplete.
Now Prescott on fourth down. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And the Dolphins are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line.
But I would not rein him back in. The return on investment thus far has been pretty good. Two touchdowns to one interception.
Meanwhile, Tua's throw caught by his receiver, Hill. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. Looking to throw again on second down. Tua buying time to his left. Tua hit and the ball is out. But this will get out of bounds. Tua gonna throw. That is caught by Waddle. Touchdown Miami. A 5-yard touchdown catch.
About that way.
But for the defense, that goal is not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit, because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit. I have enough confidence in my team and my play calling ability that I think I can always pick it up. Thus, they continue to go for it.
This will be for you, I'm sure. Here we go on fourth down. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Dolphins get the football in great field position. So just shy of midfield. They tried it. Didn't work out. What did you
think? One wanting to go for it on offense. But in this situation, it doesn't.
First half.
I don't know that there's any risk. I mean, what's the reward for your risk here? I would not have done that. My only explanation is this coach, he may want to be up here in the booth with us. We may have a three-man.
Six now. First and 10.
Three. Black one. Check right.
Looking to pass. Tua. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill. Complete. Down inside the 10. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Tyreek Hill. 36 yards. To go in the half, the question, can they put something together here, try to take that lead into intermission?
I would have to think that would be the goal for sure. I don't think you sit on anything here. Here's your opportunity. Push it downfield. As you mentioned, it's a tie game. So minus a disaster on your part, you've got that in your back pocket. Go ahead and try and get some points and feel great going into the half.
Prescott on first down. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just...
Rush coming, and he's taken down. The sack there by Bradley Chubb.
He'll give them an instant to react. It was a classic case of if you blink, you missed it. Off the line and to the quarterback in just a couple of seconds. Running back only had a moment to react and attempt to throw a block.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this punt goes out of bounds, and it'll be marked inside the 40. The Dolphins taking over now late in this first half. And with great starting field position and a couple of timeouts at their disposal, they'll certainly have the green light here. Good starting field position for the Dolphins as they have it first and 10 at their own 37. Here's Tua. And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss.
Here we go. Here we go.
Tua, the final shot before half. On the right side open is Gesicki. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So we've hit half.
During the first half. And now, here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player, all I'm thinking is, can I make a play?
Second and 12 after the loss. They'll try to throw now. Prescott. That is caught by Lamb. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield. And that last reception puts him over 150 yards now on the game, Charles.
And now it's not just execution. It's not just performance. It's a mental.
It's after the sack. It's third and long. Looking to throw. Prescott. Got an open man. It's Mike. Prescott now from the 50. Open man Lamb. It's complete. And he is going to have the Cowboys first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive. To throw again on second down. Prescott. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former Cowboy, Byron Jones. And the Dolphins are going to have the football here at the...
Ready.
They'll try and run here with Mostert. Oh, Mostert hit and he drops the ball. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line.
Well, so much for the four-minute offense. They were trying to reduce the clock, get in position to win the game. When you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run. But for both sides, they had to walk away from that field. I'm like, okay. I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And he's going to get this inside the 30. 84 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second.
All game on the ground. This is another one that keeps him moving forward.
And that one incomplete, but now a penalty flag coming in late. That might be PI.
Defense. Everyone on offense not doing their job.
That ball is caught. It's Gallup. Touchdown, Cowboys. Three touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys have broken this deadlock and have taken the lead here in the fourth. Offensively, they need their best drive of the game right here. They fake the handoff. Now Tua. Tua hit and the ball is out. Fortunate to get that football back because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Going to the air. Tagovailoa. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. And he's going to be brought down short of the... He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And he'll go ahead and field this at the 5. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And they will take over first and 10. They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
How about some
as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He did it again. We've got a one-score game with inside. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never like to see it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Caught by Wilson. And they'll get this 40-yard line. Got a man here, it's Wilson. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes it. Here's first and 10. Tagovailoa. He's going to drop this. And he loses the football a second time. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. Throwing there, but
nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
Watch out for Hill on the return. So a solid punt, but also a nice return there. A 4th and 10 at the 41-yard line. Tua. And that throw behind on 1st, now 2nd and 10. Tua to throw. He's going to let it fly. Down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. One final try for Tagovailoa. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. On a huge mistake late, it's intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.